Winter Park, Lake Mary, Claremont, Mineola, Maitland, Apopka, downtown. But wait, seriously, where should you actually live? If you're looking to move to the Orlando area, but you're a little unsure about what exact town that you want to live in, keep watching this video because I'm going to tell you the top five suburbs that you should consider when moving to the Orlando area. Let's go. These areas are mentioned based on their market popularity, atmosphere, and things to do. Now, number one, we have Oviedo. Oviedo has truly become one of the most sought out communities, and it really is amazing to see how Oviedo has grown to what it is today, considering its deep roots in chicken farming, big pieces of land, and fishing. While there's still opportunity to fish in Lake Jessup, the area has grown to be a huge suburban hub with lots of retail shops. One of the major upsides of living in Oviedo is its proximity to the University of Central Florida, which is one of the biggest colleges in the nation. I myself actually went to UCF, go Knights charge on, and lived in the Oviedo area for about 4 years. One of my favorite things to do when I lived in Oviedo was walk the Econ Wilderness Trail, which is about a 3 mile walk with lots of wild animals, including armadillos, fox squirrels, and gopher tortoises. Sorry, that's really hard to say. Now, another great thing to do in Oviedo is Oviedo on the Park, which was recently built in 2017. This is a great area for date night or to experience with the kids, as there's lots of shops, restaurants, and there actually is an amphitheater, which they host a lot of events as well. The median sales price for a home in Oviedo is around $465,000, and a lot of families do like to move to this area due to the highly rated schools. If you are a family looking to move in a more suburban area with still a lot of great things to do and only being about 25 minutes to downtown Orlando, Oviedo might be the place for you. Now, before we go into the next one, if you want to know more about moving to the Orlando area, give this video a thumbs up so other people like you can find this video, and also hit that subscribe button to know everything about the Orlando area on my channel. If you're considering moving to Orlando, you've probably heard of Winter Park a couple of times. Winter Park is one of the most popular suburbs due to its beautiful tree-lined streets, brick-paved roads, and eclectic atmosphere. The neighborhoods in Winter Park date back to the 60s, where a lot of original homes still stand, but some have also been torn down to build brand new homes, which has been becoming a little bit more popular now these days. One-off builders have been creating one-of-a-kind luxurious homes in Winter Park, which has really brought the housing market in that area to a next level. The median price for a home is around $600,000, which is a little bit higher in this area, but you pay for what you get. You do get a ton of extra incentives with moving to the Winter Park area. Not only is it a beautiful place to live, but there's lots to keep you busy in the Winter Park area. Park Avenue is one of the most popular destinations in Winter Park. It is a great area for high-end shopping, enjoying some of the best restaurants in Orlando, wine tastings, festivals, and everything in between. One of my favorite things to do in Winter Park is All Fired Up, which is actually a pottery painting place. And this place actually allows you to bring your own food and drink. So it's a great place to bring the kids, have a little kid time, but it is also a great place to bring your significant other, grab a bottle of wine, and paint some pottery. This area is perfect for families with kids because the schools are great in this area. We also have a lot of private schools in that area, but it is also great for dual income, no kids as well. Once you step foot into Winter Park, you will truly feel the charm. Next up, we have Lake Mary. Now, Lake Mary was actually rated number 4 best places to live in the US by CNN, which comes at no surprise because the neighborhoods here are absolutely gorgeous. If you're a golf person, Lake Mary might be for you because there's lots of golf course communities, including Timaquan, the Mayfair Country Club, and Heathrow Country Club. And the prices honestly really aren't that bad compared to other golf communities. The median home price in Lake Mary is around $465,000, and you can actually find homes in this area with a little bit more square footage than you can in the centralized Orlando location. Families usually flock to this area due to its high-end corporations that are located up there, including Siemens and Mitsubishi. This allows for a lot of job opportunities, and the schools over there are also very highly rated as well. You can find the Central Florida Zoo here, as well as the Botanical Gardens, and you can also visit the Lake Mary downtown area, which is a little small town with boutique restaurants and really great atmosphere. One of my favorite places in Lake Mary in the downtown area is New City Coffee, and here you can actually get flights of coffee to try all of their seasonal flavors. Some of the flavors include Teddy Graham, Birthday Cake, Bananas Foster, super unique flavors that you probably can't find at any other coffee shops, and this place was actually went viral on TikTok, so this is a great place to check out in the downtown Lake Mary area. Lake Mary is also a smaller city compared to other cities, so you're bound to make a lot of new friends with people in the area and also with colleagues as well. If you're looking for more of that small town feel, but in a bigger suburb, Lake Mary would be perfect for you. Whew, guys, I don't know if you can tell, but my hair at the beginning of this video looks completely different than it did now. The humidity is kicking today. Now on to number four, we have Lake Nona. Lake Nona has grown exponentially over such a short period of time. And if you live in the Central Florida area, you are very familiar with the Lake Nona name due to its innovations in technology and well-being. Now this is very similar to Lake Mary. Lake Nona is also moving a lot of corporate businesses over to that area to bring additional jobs and communities. At the heart of the community, you can find the Lake Nona Town Center, which offers great retail shops, awesome restaurants, and a lot of events for families, and lots of great places to get drinks as well. My favorite place to visit in Lake Nona is Boxy Park, which is actually located inside of the Lake Mary Town Center. It's just a little bit off to the side. This little Boxy Park area offers great food options. It is a little bit of a food hall and has some great events. In October, during Halloween season, they have this huge event where you can carve pumpkins. They have a stage for live events, and they actually have a sand volleyball area as well. Here, you can actually find the largest tennis campus in the country, the United States Tennis Association National Campus, and you can also find the Lake Nona Performance Club Fitness Center. In Lake Nona, the median price for a home is around $605,000, and here you can find a lot of high-end new construction communities. And it's only 20 minutes to downtown Orlando and only a short 10-minute distance to the airport, so if you do travel a lot for work, this area might be the best for you. Lastly, we have Winter Garden. Winter Garden is one of those areas that gives you the small town feel but is actually developing at a crazy speed. Winter Garden has become significantly popular over the past couple of years due to its new construction communities and its awesome downtown area. You can find a home in Winter Garden for around $560,000. And like I said, with having a really awesome downtown area, downtown Winter Garden is where you can find really charming patio cafes and sidewalk restaurants. The downtown Winter Garden Saturday market cannot be missed. It is every single Saturday, and it's where they bring in a bunch of small businesses and vendors into the downtown area, so you can buy, you know, things like food, support small businesses, clothes, thrifts, and everything in between. Locals like to run, walk, and take their dogs on the award-winning West Orange Trail, which is a part of the 250-mile coast-to-coast connector trail across Central Florida. Now, if you are looking for kind of that winter park feel, but you want to spend a little bit less money on a home, Winter Garden might be perfect for you. And those are the top five suburbs that you should consider if you are thinking about moving to the Orlando area and unsure what city you want to live in. If you found this information helpful, give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button to learn more about living in the greater Orlando area. Being a realtor in Orlando is super rewarding, as I am able to help a ton of families from across the world relocate and start their lives in Orlando. If you're looking to move to Orlando and just want a couple more cities to be able to choose from, click the link in the description to book a one-on-one call with me, and I'm happy to answer all of your questions that you may have. You can also reach me by phone and email, which is also in the description below. I will see you guys soon, and have a great rest of your day.